Today, I want to talk about Coenzyme Q10. We will explore the general benefits and the best food sources of this vital nutrient, but we will mainly focus on the people who stands to gain the most from taking Coenzyme Q10 supplements. We will examine four medical conditions that research has shown can benefit significantly from Coenzyme Q10 supplementation. I will also discuss the issue of poor absorption of Coenzyme Q10, how this can be improved, and what other nutrients work synergistically with Coenzyme Q10 to improve its effectiveness. So whether you are looking to boost your overall health or address specific health concern, stay tuned. You won't want to miss this valuable information.
Can you tell us what is Coenzyme Q10 and why do we need it?
Coenzyme Q10 plays a crucial role in energy production within our bodies. Think of it as a spark plug in your car's engine, providing necessary energy to power the cellular processes in your body. It is a naturally occurring substance found in every cell of our body, with the highest concentration in organs such as heart, liver, and kidneys. Without adequate levels of Coenzyme Q10, our cells cannot function properly, which leads to a variety of health issues.
Do we need to supplement Coenzyme Q10, or can our body make it on its own?
There is no consensus on whether we need to supplement Coenzyme Q10 from outside sources or not. Coenzyme Q10 is found in varying amounts in a wide range of foods, but the highest concentration of Coenzyme Q10s are typically found in certain animal-based foods. Organ meats such as liver and the heart are known to be one of the highest sources of Coenzyme Q10. These animal organs contain on average about 3 to 4 milligrams per 100 gram serving. But keep in mind that these foods are also high in cholesterol. So much healthier option is to get Coenzyme Q10 from fatty fish such as salmon, which contains average of 1 to 2 milligrams of Coenzyme Q10 per 100 gram serving. In addition, the very beneficial omega-3 fatty acids, which work well together with Coenzyme Q10. However, it's worth noting that the exact amount of Coenzyme Q10 present in these foods can vary depending on the animal diets and the way the food is prepared.
Can you discuss some of the consequences of not having enough Coenzyme Q10?
Definitely, a deficiency of Coenzyme Q10 can have some significant consequences. It can lead to symptoms like fatigue, muscle weakness, and intolerance to exercise, which means that you just get tired very quickly even with minimal amount of workout. This can be very frustrating for many people. One of the primary causes of Coenzyme Q10 deficiency is the use of statins, which are drugs used to lower cholesterol levels. Statins can decrease Coenzyme Q10 levels. This is because the same enzymes which is used to produce cholesterol in our bodies is also used to produce Coenzyme Q10. So when we take statins, our bodies are producing less of both cholesterol and Coenzyme Q10. Now it's important to know that while statins are effective at lowering cholesterol levels, they do have side effects. Muscle pain and weakness are common side effects of statins use, and they can be caused by depletion of Coenzyme Q10. It's therefore recommended that people who take statins also take Coenzyme Q10 supplements to help counteract these effects.
So, let's talk about the groups of people who can benefit the most from taking Coenzyme Q10.
Sure, well, when researchers looked at several randomized controlled trials on oral Coenzyme Q10 supplementation in healthy adults and athletes, interestingly enough, they saw pretty inconsistent outcomes. None of the variables that the researchers looked at were demonstrating any kind of consistent benefits. They did not see any improvements with exercise performance, prevention of muscle damage, antioxidant protection, and immunological modulation. However, the story is quite different in elderly population. As we age, our body's ability to produce Coenzyme Q10 decreases, leaving older adults at the risk for low levels of this important compound. In fact, as we age, our body's ability to produce Coenzyme Q10 in the heart decreases. By the time we reach 80 years old, our heart's production of coenzyme Q10 is only about half of what it used to be when we were 20 years old. This decline of coenzyme Q10 production is further exacerbated by the fact that many elderly individuals take prescribed medications such as statins, bisphosphonates, and beta blockers, all of which can interfere with body's natural ability to produce coenzyme Q10. Yes, that's right, bisphosphonates used for treatment of osteoporosis and beta blockers used in management of cardiovascular diseases can interfere with coenzyme Q10 production, not only statins. Fortunately, studies have shown that supplementing with coenzyme Q10 can have significant benefits for the elderly. In addition to promoting healthy aging and reducing inflammation, coenzyme Q10 improves metabolism, gene expression, and antioxidant function. Unlike healthy adults and athletes whose depleted coenzyme Q10 levels are temporary, older adults are likely to have chronically low levels of coenzyme Q10 due to aging, illnesses, and metabolic changes.
Now, why don't we look closer at four specific conditions which should, in research studies, the biggest promise from coenzyme Q10 supplementation.
Right, so let's start with little less known beneficiaries of coenzyme Q10 supplementation, and that's people who suffer with migraines. Coenzyme Q10 has been shown to help prevent and manage migraines. It may help to reduce the frequency, severity, and duration of migraines by improving the mitochondrial function. Once again, mitochondria are the little powerhouses in our body that help the cells to make energy, and coenzyme Q10 has been shown to protect them by reducing oxidative damage. Now let's move to the next one, the one important organ that most people can associate with and the one which has shown the strongest benefits from coenzyme Q10 supplementation, and that's heart. Studies have shown that coenzyme Q10 may help improve heart health by reducing oxidative stress and inflammation, supporting the energy needs of the heart muscle and improving the endothelial function. Now, why is that important? The endothelium is a thin layer of cells that lines the inner surface of the heart chambers and valves, as well as blood vessels. It is believed that coenzyme Q10 enhances endothelial function by improving the bioavailability of nitric oxide. In other words, coenzyme Q10 helps the body to make better use of the nitric oxide. That is super important because nitric oxide is a potent vasodilator, which means that it helps to dilate the blood vessels, something that we want in order to maintain a good control of our blood pressure. But the nitric oxide also regulates blood flow and reduces inflammation in arteries. Coenzyme Q10 has been shown to increase the production of nitric oxide in the endothelial cells, leading to enhanced vasodilation, improved blood flow, and reduced oxidative stress. Coenzyme Q10 has also a direct protective effect on endothelial cells by reducing the oxidative stress and inflammation. It acts as an antioxidant by scavenging free radicals and preventing oxidative damage to endothelial cells. Studies have demonstrated that coenzyme Q10 can decrease the production of pro-inflammatory cytokines, which are molecules created by the immune system to increase inflammation. Furthermore, coenzyme Q10 has been shown in some studies to reduce the bad LDL cholesterol levels and increase the good HDL cholesterol levels. When we look at all the benefits that coenzyme Q10 has for the heart, it turns out that the biggest effects were seen in management of heart failure, high blood pressure, and improving exercise tolerance in people with heart disease. Now, moving to the next condition that can benefit from coenzyme Q10, and that's Parkinson's disease. Coenzyme Q10 may help slow down the progression of the disease by improving mitochondrial function, reducing oxidative stress, and protecting neurons from damage. In Parkinson's disease, the death of the neurons that produce dopamine is caused by oxidative stress, inflammation, and mitochondrial dysfunction. Coenzyme Q10 has been suggested to have a neuroprotective effect on these neurons, meaning that it's shielding the neurons from oxidative stress and improving their mitochondrial function. Studies have shown that coenzyme Q10 can increase the level of antioxidants in the brain and reduce production of free radicals, which can damage the cells and cause inflammation. Additionally, coenzyme Q10 has been found to improve function of the mitochondria, which increases the energy production and reduces the production of reactive oxygen species. How does that all translate to the overall benefit for the patient with Parkinson's disease? Well, studies have shown that coenzyme Q10 supplementation may improve motor function and quality of life in people with Parkinson's disease, which I think is worth noting. Now, the last condition that I will discuss today that coenzyme Q10 has been shown to be beneficial for is statin-induced myalgia. We already discussed it earlier, so I'm not going to go through that in great details again, but it is worth noting that if you are taking statins and are experiencing muscle pain and weakness, you may want to talk to your healthcare provider about trying supplementation with coenzyme Q10. Now, if you have recently started taking statins and you wake up in the morning feeling like buzz hit you, contact your healthcare provider as soon as possible, because that might be a sign of more significant muscle damage that may require either adjustment of the dosage or changing the medication completely.
Now let's talk about the supplementation with coenzyme Q10. How much coenzyme Q10 should we be taking?
Research shows that the recommended dose of coenzyme Q10 supplementation is between 100 to 200 milligrams a day. It's important to know that the bioavailability of coenzyme Q10 supplements may be low, meaning that our bodies may not absorb coenzyme Q10 effectively. That is especially true in normal, healthy individuals. However, when there is a lack of coenzyme Q10 due to disease, the body may absorb more of it and make it more available to the tissue. This is supported by studies showing that older adults who took coenzyme Q10 supplements after heart procedures had higher level of coenzyme Q10 in their heart tissue. Taking coenzyme Q10 concurrently with high-fat meals not only helps to facilitate coenzyme Q10 absorption, but also reduces the gut-related side effects that some people may experience. It is also worth noting that the maximum concentration of coenzyme Q10 in the blood occurs at about 6 to 8 hours after taking the supplement. Coenzyme Q10 supplements are available in various forms such as tablets, powdered filled capsules, and oil suspension and soft gel capsules. But ubiquinol is the superior form of coenzyme Q10, and it is important to check the supplement fact label on the product to ensure you are getting the right form. If the form of coenzyme Q10 is not indicated on the label, it is most likely the less absorbable form.
What can you tell us about taking coenzyme Q10 with other nutrients? Is there any benefit?
Well, taking coenzyme Q10 alone may be beneficial, but we need to understand that people with chronic illnesses often have multiple nutrient deficiencies, which can explain why taking only coenzyme Q10 supplements can sometimes result in inconsistent outcomes, especially for those with severely compromised nutrient reserves. Therefore, combining coenzyme Q10 with other nutrients may enhance the clinical benefits in these situations. Several studies have shown that taking coenzyme Q10 supplements with multiple vitamins and minerals can protect against organ damage by reducing oxidative damage and inflammation. Common combinations include coenzyme Q10 and selenium, which is an important cofactor in glutathione peroxidase, a key antioxidant enzyme. There are other nutrients that can also help boost the energy and antioxidant systems in our cells, including B vitamins, vitamin C and E, zinc, lipoic acid, L-carnitine, and taurine. But I cannot stress enough that supplementation with any vitamin, mineral, or other nutrients will work best when it is part of a healthy diet rich in vegetables and fruits, which provide myriad of nutrients that work together to keep our body working at its best. In conclusion, we can say that coenzyme Q10 is a naturally occurring substance found in every cell of our body responsible for producing energy. While our body can produce coenzyme Q10 on its own, the amount of coenzyme Q10 that our body synthesizes decreases with age and certain health conditions or medications such as statins, which can also affect the body's ability to produce coenzyme Q10. Therefore, some people may benefit from supplementing with coenzyme Q10 to ensure that they are getting enough of this important compound. We hope you learned something new today. If you did, please give us thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to our channel so that you get notified when we publish another video.